Hello students, we will be seeing from the chapter number systems. This is the second part on operations of real numbers. So there are some important part that we need to discuss. So for operation on real numbers, first thing, there are some properties that we will see. First, if a and b are positive real numbers, then root ab can be written as root a into root b. This radical sign can be given separately if there is multiplication between two real numbers, and similar is the case in division. If it is root a by b, then it can be written as root a upon root b and vice versa. This root a upon root b can be written as root a by b. And next, if we have the multiplication between two conjugates. Now, what are conjugates? If you see root a plus root b, and this is root a minus root b. So the second term in both these numbers are same, but they have different sign. When you have two same numbers but sign is different for the second term, then they are said to be conjugate in this. So root a plus root b will have conjugate as root a minus root b. So when you multiply these two, so you will get a minus b. You can check this out by opening the brackets. Root a into root a would be a, root b into root b will be b, and other terms that you will get is root a into root b, which will be with negative sign, root b into root a, which will be positive. So since they are opposite in signs but same number, so they will cancel out each other and you will get a minus b. Similarly, if you see this, so this will be again the same term, but here you had root a, this is only a. So squaring this, you will get a square minus b, and these are four different. So, four different numbers. This is root A, root B, root C, root D. So, you multiply each term. So, you get root A into root C is root AC. Root A into D is root AD. Root B into root C will give you root BC. And root B into root D will give you root BD. So, you multiply with each term and the numbers inside the radical sign will get multiplied with themselves. And this is root A plus root B whole square. So, you apply the formula for A plus B whole square. And this is what you get. So these are some of the properties that we are going to use while solving the real numbers with the radical signs. Okay, so let's take some examples so that this will help you to solve the exercise. Now we will be using those properties. So this is 5 plus root 7 into 2 plus root 5. So what we do is, now all the numbers are different. So we will open the brackets, we will multiply each term. 5 into this bracket plus root 7 into this bracket. So this is what we have done. 5 into 2 will give you 10. 5 into root 5 is 5 root 5. Okay. Root 7 into 2 is 2 root 7. Root 7 into root 5 will be root 35. So this is how you get the answer. For this question, a plus b whole square, this is the property that you are going to use. Here you have 5 plus root 5 into 5 minus root 5. Now this is conjugate of this. So directly I can take this as a square minus b square. So now in this case, a is 5. B is root 5. So this is a plus b into a minus b, which is a square minus b square. So you get 5 square minus root 5 whole square. So this is 5 square minus root 5 whole square. So you will get 25 minus 5, which will give you 20. Now again, same in this case, it is a minus b into a plus b. Again, it is a square minus b square. So a square minus b square will give you 11 minus 7, which is 4. So this is how we go about for this questions. Next, we have one more question which says rationalize the denominator. So how to rationalize the denominator? Now rationalize means denominator should not be an irrational number. So I want rational number. So I know that if I multiply with one more root 2, then my denominator becomes root 2 into root 2, which is 2. So that will rationalize it. So I will multiply and divide both numerator and denominator by root 2. That means it is 1 by root 2 into root 2 by root 2, this part. So you get 1 into root 2 is root 2, and root 2 into root 2 becomes 2. So I have rationalized this denominator from root 2 to 2, but then I got some numerator. Okay, this was only when you have root 2 in the denominator. If suppose you have mixed number like this, 2 plus root 3. Okay, so when you have 2 plus root 3, so we will multiply with the conjugate of this denominator. Now what is the conjugate? I have explained in the last this thing while discussing the properties. So root 2, the conjugate would be, you have to just change the sign of the second number. So 2 plus root 3's conjugate would be 2 minus root 3. So to rationalize it, I will multiply and divide with the conjugate. So conjugate of 2 plus root 3 is 2 minus root 3. So multiply the numerator and the denominator with the same term, that is conjugate. So 1 into this term will give you this, and this is now in the form a plus b into a minus b, which is a square minus b square. So a square minus b square is 2 square minus root 3 square. Root 3 square will give you 3, 2 square will give you 4. 4 minus 3 is 1, so you get 2 minus root 3. So this is how you rationalize the mixed numbers, and this is how you rationalize when you have only single irrational number in the denominator. Let's see this example. So here denominator is root 3 minus root 5. So we will multiply both numerator and denominator with the conjugate of this, which is minus root 5 becomes plus root 5 in the conjugate. So it is root 3 plus root 5 upon root 3 plus root 5. Then you multiply and you simplify. For all the questions like this, you will do, you will just change the sign of the second term to make it a conjugate, and then you will multiply both numerator and denominator with the conjugate and rationalize. Thank you.